Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about ionization enthalpy. Initially we have talked about the properties of the periodic table, that is ionic size, atomic size, and now we are going to talk about the ionization enthalpy. So let us talk about it. So now let us talk about ionization enthalpy. So the amount of energy required to remove the most loosely bound electron from an isolated gaseous atom of an element in its ground state is called as ionization enthalpy. So what does this mean actually? This means that we have to remove an electron from an atom which is present in a gaseous state. So if we have removed an electron from an atom which is now present in a gaseous state, so what will happen basically? Since the atom has now no electrons because has less electrons compared to the earlier one because we have removed one electron. So even though we can remove one, we can remove multiple electrons also. So therefore this energy required to remove the loosely bonded electrons, the first loosely bonded electrons, will be known as the ionization enthalpy. For example, suppose if we have an atom named as X and it is present in a gaseous state. So what will happen actually? Since the atomic size in this case will be more and there would be an electron which would be loosely bonded with the nucleus, or basically would say it will be loosely held in the overall atom. So what we have to do is we have to remove that electron, and the energy required to remove that electron is basically known as ionization enthalpy. So therefore once I have removed the electron, so therefore this X will be turned into X plus ion while removing one electron. So therefore the energy required to remove the electron is basically known as ionization enthalpy, which is denoted by delta H of I. It is known to be ionization enthalpy as well as it is known to be ionization potential or ionization energy. So it is very easy to understand this concept. For that, let me give you another example so as you could understand this concept. Suppose when it comes to atom, so therefore the atom consists of, suppose I am talking about the sodium, so sodium contains 11 electrons as well as 11 protons. So when we are talking about the Na plus ions, so what happens is this Na plus ions will have one electron less. So there is a possibility that we could convert the Na which is present in an atomic form, and we could convert it to an Na plus ion. How? Suppose if the number of electrons that are being present in the sodium is basically 11, as we could see, that is the one will have the two electrons, one first shell will have two electrons, the second shell will have total 8 electrons, while the last shell will have a one electron. So now this is what we are talking about Na atom, that is sodium atom, which is present in a gaseous state. So in this case, as we could see, that the number of electrons in the number of shells in this case is 1, 2, and 3. The main shells are 3, and this electron, this is the outermost electron or the loosely bonded electron of the sodium atom. So because in this case the nucleus will have not that much of influence to this electrons, because it is compared to the other electrons, it is mostly loosely bonded electron. So therefore we have to remove this electron, and for that we will require energy. So suppose if we have removed this electron, so now this sodium which was present in an atomic form will now be converted into a Na plus ion by removing one electron. So we have removed one electron. So the energy required to remove this loosely bonded electron is nothing known as ionization enthalpy, and moreover we could say that we have converted an atom into an ion, and that ion is positive. So ionization enthalpy is only related to conversion of an atom into an ion, or conversion of an ion into more positive ion. So therefore this is how we have converted an atom into an ion. So this process is basically known as ionization enthalpy. This process is known as ionization, and the energy required to remove the electron is known as ionization enthalpy. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly. So share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.